It's been a long 3 months for these Bella Vista homeowners, no longer neighbours, but closer than ever.
Our health has deteriorated. I've had numerous doctor's appointments, hospital visits with both my kids, especially my son has been really sick through this.
In March, the Stewarts were one of 20 families told to pack their bags and evacuate as a cyclone approached. There were fears their homes wouldn't be safe in the storm.
We were threatened by council staff that if we did not go, we'd be forcibly removed from our house.
In the following months, further assessments exposed structural and technical issues, despite some properties having code of compliance. That forced Tauranga Council to commission a report into the development's failings and whether council was also at fault in its handling of events. Events that would tear young families apart.
It's put a strain on my marriage, our family dynamics, our jobs, and moving around traumatised my daughter so much that when we finally got back home, temporarily, she said, "I'm not going to unpack my bag because the man's just going to move us again."
Sasha Tyrell poured her life savings into her property. Her marriage suffered as a result, as did her daughter's health, as their new home was damp, among other more alarming problems.
The wrong bolts were used in places, that washers were not used where they should have been, that hand railings were not fixed properly on my deck on the second floor of my house. That is a deck that my two-year-old played on.
Bella Vista's director Danny Kansian spent 4 years in a Chinese jail for killing a man who died after a fight. On his return to New Zealand, he moved into property development, which led to the Bella Vista project. It went into liquidation last year. A report presented to Tauranga Council a short time ago highlighted some major failings on its part and has recommended residents should be compensated. Tauranga City Council has just announced it'll purchase the properties, but still faces questions around how this could have happened. Sam Calloway, One News.